over. We get a completely new pick and a very kind of different strategy from Secret. We'll see Zai looking to create tons of space for the rest of his team to let the Slaughter, Shadow Fiend kind of... It's going to be more of a four-man Death Ball rather than a five-man Death Ball when you have the Broodmother in your team. And yes, Winter Wyvern, his first appearance at the Red Bull Battlegrounds Dota 2 tournament and my first time seeing this hero in competitive Dota.
Yeah, mine as well. I believe I may have seen him picked once in, it might have been Dream League or one of the other European leagues that have been ongoing, but hardly a go-to pick by any means. So with that, we get underway with game number two, and we're going to quickly run through our lineups here. On the Radiant side, we've got Secret, beginning with Arteezy. He'll be playing the Shadow Fiend. Kuroki on the Winter Wyvern nearby will be S4 on the Slardar, Puppy on the Drow, and my oh my gods, we might have a clash off the bat. Faith looking for the lift, he's just been revealed, but unable to find Puppy. Some fancy footwork, steps into the trees, and will make his way out. And rounding out Secret, of course, Zai on that Brood, but we might not be done yet. Let's wait and see if IG are going to stick around.
I want to set up camp here for now, get them some vision, and try and use the fog to their advantage to maybe find a pickoff, but...
There's always that tango through kind of play that they could go for, and they're going to try to find Puppy. They get the lift up. Could be the first blood. Out comes the Shadow Strike, and in come the auto attacks. Puppy will be brought down, and first blood is spilt by IG.
Yeah. Really right. Nice ward. That does reveal to Puppy roughly where the ward is, because the only way you know the timing of that tango through is with a ward.
Well, with that said, we'll now go ahead and quickly run through IG. Hopefully the players will cooperate and not kill each other anymore. We've got Chuan playing the Visage, something that we saw Kuroki dominate with the past two times he's played it. Faith on the Rubick, and rounding out the tri lane is going to be Burning. Normally known for more of his hard carries, but he will be on the Brew this time around. In the mid lane, we wanted a more aggressive, iconic 430 hero, and gods, we're going to get it. He's on the Queen of Pain against a Shadow Fiend. A very old school matchup, and that will round things out for IG. With Luo, who has the tough task of dealing with the endless Broodmother onslaught.
I'm really curious to see how some of these 1v1 matchups goes. 430 versus Arteezy mid, and the Luo versus Zai matchup. This was a very crucial matchup last game, and just one solo kill from Phoenix onto the Darkseid made a big difference last game. One of the things which didn't really get highlighted too much, but that can really turn the... It gave Secret that little bit of extra momentum going into the mid game.
I want to ask you, what are your thoughts on the Winter Wyvern pick this game? Looking at the hero, it feels like the main benefit to the hero more than anything is just how good it is against heavy physical damage. That's where a lot of people in the past patch, which was very physical damage based, the Juggernaut, Troll, Sniper picks being the go-to ones, were saying if Winter Wyvern was in this patch, it would be the counter to these strategies. Do you see the hero being useful in that role this game, or if not, why Winter Wyvern?
I don't think his physical damage negation is going to be a huge part of this game. Just looking at the IG draft, the physical damage is somewhat it's not really there. The heal, if they want to group up and push a lot, is really nice. And also the Winter's Curse, providing an instant lockdown disable. If you can catch the Brew when he blinks into clap ulti before he ultis, you can theoretically burst him out, and they haven't got really anyone to save the Brewmas if he gets caught by that ultimate of the Winter Wyvern. Similarly, locking down someone like 430 on Queen of Pain. I feel like the ulti is one of the big reasons that this hero has been picked, as well as that first skill. Arctic Burn is just incredibly potent, giving you that extra range and that kind of percent-based damage that burn through IG's tanky core's HP.
Yeah, even early on, we could see it's pretty good for just lane control and harassment from Kuroki, so looking forward to seeing how it shapes up here. For now, looking at the tri-lane for Secret, things have stabilized, and it seems this game is going to be a lot more even when it comes to CS gods. At least early on, nobody with an overwhelming advantage, largely because we're not seeing a lane-dominant strategy like that Drow Visage.
Yeah, one thing, the Bristleback will use his early quills. He needs to get a bottle out to him ASAP, I feel. Otherwise, Luo maybe will struggle against Zai in this top lane. He won't have good HP or mana regen without the bottle, and that's where 430 may have to give up some kind of courier control to help out Bristleback in the safe lane.
For now, in the mid lane, though, Arteezy doing a really nice job here. 430, I mean, unable to really get that dominant start that you're looking for. He did come to the lane a little bit late. I'm not sure if he got a great block off, and normally these are the levels where if you're Queen of Pain, you need to be ahead on Shadow Fiend, or it does get hard to continue to dominate.
We'll see if with this trial lane versus trial lane, it does tie up the IG supports. If they want to be able to hold their own in this 3v3 matchup, they can't really afford to risk sending someone to the mid lane to gank the Shadow Fiend without making someone like Burning on Brew or whichever support stays behind very vulnerable to some aggression coming out of Team Secret.
And good news, you know, you mentioned that ward should be pretty easy to deward, but it wasn't. And on top of that, the camp was never dewarded. So Secret Secret, despite holding the defensive trialing position, normally you can get ahead with pulls here. Not even able to get off a single one. IG are preventing them, and now they're making their go in on S4. They get up the clap. Out comes the Grave Chill. The follow-up might be their Soul Assumption. They got him. Kurogi too late with the save attempt. And now the chase onto Puppy. Another Soul Assumption. Man, that Visage doing work. Normally, we don't see him in this kind of aggressive role nowadays. And Burning's going to make it a double. Gets the clap off. You know, it used to be that Visage was the lane dominator in the age of aggressive tri-lanes, 3v3 action, but then the Visage really fell into this niche role of playing that slightly greedier farming support and didn't come online until he got the familiars. But this is kind of a taste of the old school Visage gods.
Yeah, this is really potent. And the big thing, as you mentioned, not having a pull camp available for Secret means all they can do is farm the lane. These supports can just sit behind S4 and look to counter-initiate aggression, but if you get the good liftoff, as they did on the Slaughter, pull them into your two supports on the IG side, there's no real escape. All you can hope for is that S4 is tanky enough to survive it, but he didn't even get his magic stick off, it looks like, and brought down IG with a quick early game advantage with 3 kills up on Secret, and Secret say this bottom lane is lost. Let's rotate supports and try and make something else happen in other places on the map.
Well, I mean, look at this top lane. Luo's having a great time of it. He did not go for... I'm not sure if he went for the early bottle here, but he's already able to just stay in lane for ages with the Ring of Health, and he's holding off the Brood pretty nicely. Zai getting good farm in his own right, but as long as you're not losing that tower and the Brood's not really snowballing, you're, I think, quite content with that lane. So that's where I think the key for Seeker right now is. Arteezy is having a very good time, and he is just dominating. At this point, 4:30.
Yeah, this is where Queen of Pain can use your nuke a bit to last hit, but this is a huge win for Arteezy and Team Secret as a whole.
And like you mentioned, they really can't gank. Not only is the trialing tied up, but the Bristleback can't leave the lane, because if he does, he loses his tower. So they're powerless to do anything to turn this lane around.
And now with the high ground lane ward as well, that just helps Arteezy out even more. He can throw raises onto creeps and try and clip 4:30, keep him low as well at the same time. And that's something 4:30 doesn't realize it's there. We could look at an early kill potentially happening onto 4:30, or even a solo kill from Arteezy if he uses that vision to his advantage.
He did even go for the double Shadow Strike build. Normally what you do see in the 1v1 is Queen of Pain looks to pull ahead early, zone you out, but at this point, it's going to hurt you a bit in clearing the waves and rune control. May have to sacrifice some creeps to go it, as we will see a little slow coming out from Kuroki. No follow-up just yet, though. IG starting to group up 4 heroes to secure the Hippodam rune, and Arteezy says, great, I'll take the top one for free.
Yeah, so even though the start was amazing for IG with the kills and just getting CS in all 3 lanes, they're kind of struggling now. There's great Radiant Vision up, which can protect the mid lane Shadow Fiend. They can also scout the movements of IG in the bottom lane. And it looks like Arteezy has in mind a sneaky little rotation, but does get scouted out by a Dire Observer Ward. If there's no top Observer Ward to scout out his move up top, you're very likely looking at a kill and a T1 tower. And as it is, this T1 tower may go down with that TP out.
IG looking to break down these lanes. Puppy will be the first man scouted out. Out comes the Shadow Strike, and he's got nowhere to run. Soul Assumption's there, no deny. Actually, does get denied by the neutral in the end.
My.
No teammates were around, but that's okay. The neutral's the Secret MVP right now.
S4 stuck.
They are looking for more here. They find S4, the creeps giving vision. He gets lifted before he can come out with the crush, and now nuked into oblivion. Down he goes, but the trade is tough, where Secret will take a tier 1 uncontested.
That's okay for Secret. I feel like they cut their losses pretty nicely there. The fact that Puppy got denied, they lose S4, who's pretty important, and kind of as one of the things the analyst said, is that not a good catch-up here, but the fact that you're getting a T1 tower, Arteezy and Zaya snowballing, and Puppy even TP'd minutes, had time to get some XP, some last hits, even just basic items towards your boots, magic stick can help out a lot, so I feel like across the board it was not as big a loss as the top kill score suggests right there for Secret.
Look at this emphasis on Luo. They're going to come in with a double raise, and they'll get it done! Secret unloading on Luo, who is not prepared for it. I mean, why should you be? Shadow Fiend normally does not camp the enemy safe lane. He's normally farming his stacks, especially Arteezy. This is just a total curveball from Secret, and IG caught unprepared.
Yeah, imagine we may see Zai pick up an early Midas off of this. He's probably got it in the next minute or so, and up to 1,900 gold. As for S4, constantly being pressured at bottom lane, and level 4 under farm. This is not going to be a game where S4 can really control the tempo as he'd like to on his kind of traditional tempo controllers.
And that is a big concern, because he's really the only reliable way for them to start fights at this stage of the game.
Yeah, so we'll see. There's still good news across the board elsewhere on the secret side. That's where two of the three lanes have been won, and already a tower down to give everyone a little bit of money to work with.
And if you're IG Guts, it really feels like it's up to the Burning Brewmaster. He's not yet level 6 yet, but he should have a Blink Dagger very soon, and he's got to make some plays for the team. Secret, knowing that split's not quite ready, they show four heroes mid. Perhaps we need to group up and go for something. Not really forcing it too much, though. They're just content to leave the Brew top, who gets solo killed by Luo. Wow, that was not expected.
Okay. You know, every now and then, Luo just comes up with an amazing play that you're just, like, left scratch your head like, man, why can he do this every game?
I mean, especially in that matchup. Normally, Brood can just run away from the Quills, but yeah. I guess let's let them stack up a bit too much.
The Soul Rings was used, so maybe just lost a bit of extra HP with the Soul Ring, and suddenly, like, with Spiderlings, you proc an extra Bristleback spray, and then suddenly,
bam,
a couple more sprays and some minus HP from the Soul Ring, and you're dead. But, yeah, that was... Not something that should happen. Zai's first big mistake.
And he was pretty far ahead as well, so that's a nice win of momentum.
While that was happening, Burning also pushed this bottom T1 tower, which matters quite a lot because it really accelerates him towards his Blink Dagger. Considering he went for a Magic Stick, Treads, Bassy Ring, he spent a lot of money on these early game items, which slowed down like at what could be a 10 or 11 naked Blink Dagger, but now with the tower money, he can get it a whole lot faster.
And again, they want to go on Luo, the tankiest hero in the game, and they're going to use the Brutal, engaging onto him. He's just going to start walking away. I don't think they can kill him now with the Vanguard out. They'll need some other hero if they want to make that move. So. And they didn't have it.
The other good thing for IG is they've got an amazing four position support to get farm on. Visage can benefit a lot from items this game. I feel like the secret side, Winter Wyvern, not a very farm dependent support, neither is the Ventral Spirit. They've gone for this like two support duo that where they're both very defensive, looking to protect a carry hero. They don't have that really farm greedy four position support, which seems very popular in 6.84 to kind of take advantage of the new gold distribution across the board.
And it's a big change for Secret, where normally Kuroki gets a very farm dependent hero.
Yeah.
Someone like Rubick, maybe you don't need a lot early, but you can use it a lot. And they don't really have it, as you mentioned. So with that said, Secret counting more on their cores, and it could end up being one of those games where it's basically a 2v5 as S4 continues to struggle to find his farm. The amp damage will always be useful, but if he's under farm, he blinks in to go for a crush, and he's likely going down. Still, though, Guts, we have not seen a split yet. IG, although leading 6-1, in terms of net worth, the two top farmers are still on Secret.
Yeah, and that's where our TZ, you want to just protect him that little bit more to get towards that mech. Very important not to let him get ganked here. It almost feels like they're happy to let S4 just get ganked and killed a few more times because he's already behind. You protect him, well, maybe you secure him a few last hits.
They're going to make the move now. They find Kuroki, but they won Arteezy. Faith jumps past looking for him, but gets slowed down by the Winter Wyvern. Can't get a range. There's a Blake, a Scream, Requiem will force him back. Our 430, not wanting to engage. Now the raises could be in danger. Good land, but it doesn't matter. Actually, does. Out comes the stick. The ult. They turn it. Luo in the front lines now. Good embrace there. Trying to keep Arteezy alive for a bit longer, but now Luo will lay into him. And one last swipe of that burning nunchuck. And down he will go. Ends up being a 2-for-1. Amazing that 430 lived that long. Held the stick, baited everyone, including me as a commentator.
If the Brute didn't rotate from top lane, he would have lived as well. That last right click from Arteezy had him, except for the stick charges.
Still, though, although it ends up being a win there for IG in terms of the kill trade, Zai again strikes back. He'll take down the tier 2 top, and he will now have free reign over the IG jungle, who don't have that great Brood ganking here in the mid game. No Storm, no Batrider. They are going to, no Slardar for that matter. They're really going to struggle to shut Zai down.
You've got to be very careful though now if you're Secret. You've got Burning just picked up his Blink Dagger even before that fight, I believe, and got a double kill and didn't even have to use the split, which is where IG will continue to look to be aggressive. Whenever split's available, there's no reason for them to just sit around, not go Genki, or not try to look to push down towers.
IG on a bit of a mission here. They'll find S4 bottom, and he gets delayed again, lifted before he can crush. Faith has been all over him. That's at least the second, if not the third time, that the lift has prevented a crush, and it seems that's really the counter to the Slardar, is just quick fingers from Faith.
Yeah, they give Chuan the lane to get farm, try to get his level 6 up, finish off a medallion to help you take Roshan later on, and they're not done. They're going to catch up Kuro now in the trees, and Ferrari there. They're going to use the Brew Split to secure this kill. Kuro can do nothing but watch his carcass. Fallen. Uh-oh. Still no mech. Arteezy caught out here in the mid lane underneath this tier 2 tower. He's got the protection of that, but that may not be enough. 430's got another scream, and Arteezy, solo subject scream. Arteezy trying to wind himself back up. Still alive. Raids one. He turns it around with the support of Zai. IG overextend and get punished.
Juan's gonna fall as well. It's three down just for the Winter Wyvern buyback. What a swing of momentum. Excellent decision making there by Arteezy. And IG, they thought he was a lot squishier than he actually was. Once you have the buckler activated, he's not easy to bring out, and that's before the mech comes out. Now you have to worry about S4 potentially getting a little more. They're going to put Luo under, and they will bring him down. 430 has the ult. Can he get in range to kill anyone off? He's got to be careful about jumping in here. They try to deal with the spider lanes. The other thing that was a little surprising there, Guts, was the rotation. Not expecting the Brood to join a fight like that generally, but in he came. Caught them off guard.
Just winds up, dishes out some damage to secure a T1 tower, and why not at this point?
Far, he tried to walk in, but he gets tossed back by a swap right into the mech. Excellent teamwork from Secret. That lift could have led to his demise otherwise, and meanwhile, an Orchid comes out. Zai, suddenly, 8,300 net worth.
And he's going to look to keep on fighting, I imagine, at least control this top lane. This makes it so that IG can't just bring someone like Queen of Pain to the top lane to solo defend. Even a Brewmaster could theoretically struggle against the Orchid with one hero assisting. And
well, they like that graph.
At least some of the half the fans do.
Yeah, the ones that don't, they're not booing, which means they're not really talking very much right now. But can't feel too good if you're an IG fan to see something like that.
Yeah, the two top farmers still heavily on the Secret side. Brood's still one of those heroes that does not scale amazingly well into the late game. And that's where things can quickly turn in the IG favor with a pickoff or two on a Brood who's the top net worth hero. And with just an Orchid, this is a very, very vulnerable hero in the top lane alone. And that's somewhere I feel IG may look to focus their efforts in the near future.
IG for now just trying to deal with the Brood onslaught. And as that Brood pushes out the top lane and as mid lane goes past the river, Secret have just so much room to maneuver in all kinds of places they could look to go. Where are they going to make their first move? Burning on the low ground. He needs to get off the split. He blinks in. S4 not going on him. Clap comes out. Now the split is there, but where's the follow-up? The bristle slowly working on the puppy. Maybe they get this kill, but doesn't matter that he got put under by the Winter Wyvern, because out comes the Queen of Pain. They get one. They're looking for Arteezy isolated. This could be good for IG. A massive quantity of heroes descending on the fight, but the turn from Artor gets off the raises, dies with the Requiem death, and not enough to turn the fight. Luo now on the top side. Zai trying to force him back. Can't get the job done, though. Will be forced off. Do they have detection? Nothing here. At
that
least not yet.
Really nice by Burning on the Brewmaster there. Throwing Arteezy up in the air, and then you go for the other heroes. And Burning can't protect the... Arteezy can't protect them with the mech because he's used up in the air, and it forces the entire Secret team to run away when they don't have that heal from the mech. And then when they run away, Arteezy suddenly alone, 1v4. He had no chance to stay alive himself. Just good execution for IG, but they do lose a lot of damage. So Secret is still making the best of that exchange.
Yeah, that top tower always under heavy assault, as we're going to see the graph plateau a bit here. You know, the Winter Wyvern has not felt that impactful this game. Oftentimes when you see this hero really shine, you put someone under with Cold Embrace and the whole enemy team's trying to hit them, doing nothing. Hero's healing up, but every time he does that, there's just a Queen of Pain ult or a nuke from the Visage, and the heroes die anyway. We just haven't really seen this hero work the way like the Dazzle did last game, where it just keeps a carry alive for ages and ages. 430, though, the unveiling of the Orchid in a fight, at least, gets caught mid. There's the limp. 430 maybe looking to turn this. Doesn't quite have the backup there, but Faith has just been everywhere for IG, and it's on 2,600 net worth.
And 430 has not had much luck this game finding any farm. He's got a great scoreline, 2-1-6, but his net worth is pretty lackluster compared to the Shadow Fiend, the Brood, and even his two other cores on his team. He has completely been crushed mid lane as far as CS goes.
Yeah, he had the 1v1 that you look for, and there was no Drowar or any sort of support movement on mid. It was just a man fight, and Artor came out on top that time around. Ever since then, he's been on a roll.
And we'll see how things progress from here. They're still looking for the S4 Blink Dagger. When you play from behind here, you just can't afford to go for something like a Vanguard. He's their main initiator. Blink Dagger is number one priority for S4, and he's still not quite there.
Well, Secret, they ducked back in for smoke, and the two IG wards in the neighborhood, but I don't think any of them actually saw that smoke. Kind of good positioning here from Secret.
See what IG,
looking for a pickoff.
IG are worried about Roche. And they'll see no one in there.
Do they want to risk this? I think they've got the Burning Vlads now on his brew. No, not quite yet. Might be coming
out. By the way, Rubik stole the spawn Spiderling, so he's using those to push out lanes, farm, and he can even use them to scout the map, which is pretty handy for Faith.
Secret going to show two heroes mid. Either they don't know or they don't care, but this Roche is about to drop, and IG grab a big pickup. They're going to give that Aegis to 430. And they really don't lose anything because they had already lost the two towers top. Mid gets shoved in a bit by Secret, and they'll lose some creep camps in the jungle. Overall, though, IG going to be very not getting the Aegis for themselves, but more importantly, slowing down any potential high ground push from Secret.
The great thing about Roche is you have five heroes missing from the map, so if Secret's one thing they weren't expecting, Roshan, and they're thinking they're five-man smoke ganking, they're trying to pick off someone like Zai. Zai was not pushing out the top and pressuring the tier 3 because he sees five heroes missing. He assumes he's being ganked up on the map, and not the case.
Now, that item we just saw on the Fishman could be very big. That is a bountiful pile of spiderlings in the meanwhile that Luo is looking to farm up. Still, though, not really able to keep up.
Hopefully no arachnophobes in the audience with the Rubick and...
The double spider action. You see spiders being killed on one side, being chased and hunted on the other. Or maybe the arachnophobes are happy because there's so many spiders dying.
I know some people, they use that little custom mod so Brood doesn't look like a Brood.
Yeah, it's the arachnophobe mod. It's nice. They're going to make their going puppy. They've cornered him in pretty bad here. Nowhere to go. Nowhere to run. Doesn't even get a chance to spend his gold. He'll get swapped, but to no avail.
Yeah, so for IG, they're going to keep looking to find pick-up.
Top lane, meanwhile, we might have a go here. I engaging on Luo. The follow-up's coming potentially from the Winter Wyvern, but he's got a completed Crimson Guard. Good luck. Secret still working on Luo. They bring in S4, and with the Amp, that's where he may drop. Quickly, no! The Quills almost put killing on Zai. He does get saved by the Winter Wyvern. They get the kill, but Burning arrives. Now the Met coming out, turning with the raises. The split's there to someone negate it. S4 going to blink back. They cyclone up Artor, and reinforcements come in now. If they can get the Shadow Fiend, that is a big takedown. He gets boulder tossed. Where's the reinforcements? Familiar's busy dealing with other heroes. A Cyclone again. IG may just be backing off. Another blink. Crush on two. IG unable to finish him off. A Queen of Painold barely tickles S4. He gets healed up, but also kept in place for S4 to be finished off. Kind of a tough situation for Kuroki, and now Arteezy. 1v3, maybe 4. Can't do it alone. Raze is being chumped out. Willy nilly, but he will die. And then to just rub some salt in the wound, Faith will finish it off by stealing and using his own Requiem against him.
Oh man, IG getting so much out of the farm. The top that fight, so much farm on a Brood, and then Bernie comes in, gets a solo kill after Bristle goes down, and this is just Luo at his best. When he's creating this much space, staying alive for that long, his team took a long time to show up and come in, but Luo done so much. He did more damage than any of his teammates that fight with the constant quill stacks onto the Broodmother, and even the other heroes like Slaughter chasing him in. Can really see the vulnerabilities in the Secret lineup considering how far behind S4 is. He blinks in, crashes, helps secure one kill, but then there's no escape plan for him. He's down to sub 5k net worth at the moment.
You know, the other thing is that looking at the way that fight progressed, they committed a lot to Luo, and you have to know IG are going to rotate. This team has been rotating extremely quickly both games. It feels like maybe they're just worrying too much about the Bristleback. Sure, he's a scary late gamer, but he's just not the easy kill that they're looking for. They'll find Zai in the tree line. Familiars come out with the medallion here. Zai drops fast. Stuns were used, and down he goes. Death by spiderlings for the spider. A tragic way to go. That's just brutal stuff.
And that's a 1,100, 1,200 gold swing just from one kill with the Brood having
that much. They're not done yet. They want the little spiderlings as well. Burning's going to massacre those two. Ay, ay, ay.
What was once a Team Secret lead is now back to zero here as we get ourselves into the mid game. And IG, Visage Brewmaster, this is just a great recipe for some good old five-man death ball, which IG may look to turn around on Secret after what happened in game one. And no real towers taken apart from the T1 a long time ago by Burning. And I think IG looking to change that here in the top lane and possibly elsewhere on the map.
They've got the Brew split available. He has already picked up the Vlads, as we mentioned earlier. Now the Ogre Club comes out. Could be that early BKB. Maybe we even just see him built straight into an Hecatomb Scepter. But for now, they will take the tower unchecked. Secret. That early lead they accumulated, Guts, part of it was tower gold. And as IG equalized the tower score, they're going to start to pull ahead here in terms of net worth.
Yeah, absolutely. Their support's getting very scary as well. This is getting to the point where Secret have two defensive five-position supports. IG have two playmaking farm supports. You've got a Visage up to 2.4k gold. You've got your Rubick Faith with a Blink Dagger completed. This is scary for Team Secret when, on the IG side, you have five heroes who are going to have a big impact in a fight. On the Secret side, the two supports, not that they're not going to have an impact, but damage wise and the kind of team fight wise, it's very defensive.
Oh, they're looking to use it. The big Blink Dagger unveil, limp, toss back, out comes the nukes, and down goes Zai. And this is always the worry with a Brood pick, is you get the Midas, especially gods, you get ahead in net worth, you get ahead in terms of experience, and then you're just like a pinata. They just start swinging that bat at you, and if you pop open, all kinds of delights await within for IG.
The Orchid pick, it's nice.
Not done. Another Blink. Follow-up Lamp. They do get the crush on two, but leaping forward is burning. Hasn't even used the split yet, and they get another kill. IG just starting to take advantage of Secret.
Yeah. Especially the Brood. Now, the one thing there, I feel like the Orchid is one of those items which sometimes works and is amazing, but more often than not when I see it picked up, the Brood just becomes too squishy with it and doesn't actually pose a big enough split push threat. If Zai had a Necro 3 when he went for that high ground tier 3 push earlier, he likely gets that tier 3 tower. So I feel like he may be regretting this Orchid pickup at this point, where he doesn't have a defensive item like BKB, doesn't have a pushing item like Necro Book, and he's not finding kills, because IG see the Orchid and they say, okay, we're never sending a hero alone top lane against the Brood. If we're going top lane, it's with 2, 3, 4 heroes, and we're killing the Brood before he can do anything with his Orchid.
IG starting to press back in this game, number two. Could bring the series back to even. A Secret firmly on the defensive. Brood, not even close to the enemy side of the map. Not even thinking about a Roshan attempt, despite the massive minus armor. You have Shadow Fiend, Slard Art Venge, and I mean, good luck walking to the pit, gods. It's an IG infestation all the way. They pressure forward. They do maybe consider a go here on Puppy, though. They know someone's got to be lurking behind him. Seems they don't even want to risk that bait.
I know the teams are talking like they, oh, we want a 3-0 or a 3-1, but this is what all the fans wanted, a close five-game series. Everyone I talked to, even other players from Malaysia, from Summer's Rift, were like, we want five games.
This is bad. IG stealing a nice big stack of Ancients here. And with this, Burning's Brewmaster, he's been fighting all game, and he's almost even in net worth with a Midas Brood who got two early towers. This is trouble.
It took a while, but finally IG break out in the top two of farmers, but I don't even think they care. Even if the Brood as well Shadow Fiend are more farm than Burning, their five-man composition is just so scary right now. And they'll have their eyes on the next Roshan before they start looking to push and take more objectives. And more than anything, I feel like they're just teamfight ready. They'll take any teamfight Secret throw at them. The one thing that's kind of pesky is the Arteezy BKB, but if they can throw him up in the air or force an early BKB by Brewmaster initiating, I mean, Brew, he's kind of guaranteed to go for his split now that he's got a BKB of his own.
Somewhat of a, I wouldn't say desperation smoke, but kind of a long ball here from Secret. Yep. The lane's pushing out for IG. They seem to know something's up. They move back very quickly, about within 10 seconds of the smoke, and they're ready for it. In fact, they might even go in, gods. The pings come out. Puppy starts the fight with a swap. They look to blow up 430. Requiem's there, and they quickly get the job done. It's Burning is stunned, but he will get off the split, trying to deal with these BKBs. The Venge will fall, an expected loss for Secret, but Zai's next run over by the Visage. Cyclone onto the Winter Wyvern, who's yet to really have an impact in these fights and tries to keep himself alive. Another Solus subject should end him. More importantly, Arteezy isolated Burning. Quick on the chase. TP out. Is there a lift waiting? Any sort of stun? He gets out! Artur able to survive, but still heavy damage. Secret just don't have the firepower. They got the swap Requiem, but they could not stop the Burning split. They don't have the physical damage, and when he gets that split off, feels like the fight's just over.
Say what you want about Burning being known for his hard carry, but his Brewmaster is up there with the best of them.
Those micro skills have been impressive.
And he just sends off his... He throws up the... He knows he has the Winter Wyvern, so he just goes chasing after the Shadow Fiend. Even though Arteezy ends up escaping, it was just perfect decision-making, again, coming out from his Brewmaster. And IG really being kept in this game, at least in the early game when they were behind by it, and now getting further and further ahead of Secret based on some of his plays and decision-making in these fights.
Oh, that's for letting Luo know that he's here, but Luo's like, eh. You don't really scare me.
S4 doesn't scare anyone this game.
The only way he can really have much of an impact is just getting that multiple hero crush and getting an amp off on a key team fight hero. They can't burst the Brew, so...
They tried. They even got the Winter's Curse.
What do you do at that point?
Yeah, if you can kill him during the Winter's Curse before he splits, I think that was the plan there. Focus too much on Queen of Pain, though.
I feel like what they either have to catch him without the BKB, or they need an MKB on maybe Arteezy, but
yeah,
that's looking pretty far forward in this game, by which point Visage, already an Ags out, we're going to see maybe an Assault Cuirass coming for IG, and their own physical damage gets out of control pretty fast.
I mean, going back to the Winter Wyvern peak, I think part of the game plan for Secret is to have an ulti that pierces BKB and then a ton of physical damage. That's where Winter Wyvern synergizes well with drafts that had physical damage because you're guaranteed to lock down a hero. It's essentially a roar in that sense, except it's hard for the IG team to back up the hero who gets roared, or in this case, caught out by the Winter's Curse.
Yeah, part of the problem feels like the Kuro just fell behind early. So by the time he's able to start using that spell, Burning already has his Blink Dagger. He'd completed the Blads. He's now level 16 with the BKB. Like, he's just been playing from behind on the Winter Wyvern, so they haven't really had opportunities to burst anyone, and Brew is great against all that. You try to focus him with Winter's Curse, he has evasion, potentially there's a Drunken Haze in the mix. Not very easy to bring him down.
Yeah,
and I think more than anything, S4, he's now getting outfarmed by both IG supports. That is bad news for Team Secret.
Oh, they're going to break through the Roshan there rather easily. IG grab the Aegis. They immediately smoke. Let's see what Secret look to do. They go from trying to force the smoke ganks earlier to now, gods, probably wanting to play some keep away Dota. Something Arteezy is very used to historically.
Now, not the easiest hero to go in. Even with the Blink Hex to prevent a BKB, there's Swap, there's the Winter Wyvern, there's a lot of potential counter gank.
Only if they're together, though. IG maybe going to find someone. Kuro off to the left. They get vision on him. They blink to the north. They look for Arteezy, and they will get him. There's the crit. Follow up. There's no Swap available, but he does BKB. Quick TP out. Queen of Pedal. It's too much. IG just blasts through our tour, and they're not losing anything. They hold the bottom lane. TP's coming out, and that is the hero that has to get fat if Secret want to take this late. Broodmother is going to fall off. We've already started to see it. The Slardar's just not getting enough in the way of CS to be anything but a support and utility hero. The deaths on Arteezy just matter so much here for IG.
And the other thing, when IG's support duo has just been incredible.
Like you said, they're basically cores at this point.
Yeah. Faith Seals Crush. He's now got a Blink Stun Initiation.
With the lift to set it all up as well.
And then you've got Visage. Medallion. Acceptor hasn't upgraded to the Solar Crest yet, but you imagine that it's going to be coming up soon now with the gold that he's banked up.
Oh, Chuan going to find Kuro. Looks for the easy solo kill, and he'll get it. 430 with the KS, but Chuan doing like 80, 90% of the damage there. Secret, it just feels like they're kind of lost. What do you do now? You can't win the fights. You can't really control the map because IG are always pushing out the lanes. You can't gank the Bristle. He's too tanky. The Queen of Pain, a bit too mobile generally. They don't have that reliable initiation aside from a Blink Crush, and Burning's got a BKB. They're just entirely on the back foot, searching for some way to catch IG off guard and just slow the game down.
Yeah, this is, you take a page out of the Admiral Bulldog book. You rat here. This is where you split push, you avoid fights. You cannot afford to take 5-on-5 engagements.
This could just set the game on a downward spiral for Secret if IG find this pick.
They've got the lineup to split push as well. Brood and Shadowfiend both great at doing it, and then it's going to be up to the support, someone like Puppy, to be sitting behind one or two of the cores. So when IG look to punish that split push, Puppy needs to be there, swap him out, and then throw away his life to save someone like Shadowfiend or Brood. I feel like that's the general game plan for Secret moving forward, but there's so much catch potential from IG, especially with the Scythe of Vice on Queen of Pain.
What are your thoughts on going back for the completed Sanjin Yasha here we see on Arteezy? He, I believe, had the Yasha, went into BKB, has now gone back for SNY. We generally don't see this on Shadowfiend, and if we do, it's normally when a team's just rolling the game over. Do you like this item? Oh, we might have a Clash mid in the meanwhile.
So what IG look to do? It seems just like a neutral buy. Like, it doesn't really... It does a bit of everything.
Uh-oh, 430. Gotta work on that Blink, man. He just wants a little rest. Wants some respite here in the trees. And he was hasted too. Rather unfortunate, but he's gonna find one. It's S4. He comes in on, gets up the Hex to start. The slow to follow Scream coming out. They do have the BKB from Burning. Getting off the clap. He dodges the stun and will get the kill. Kuro TP's in. Burning wanted to go for more, but... good call by IG not to overcommit to that. Maybe, bro, you can blow the Bruce Blink, get one more, but they want to hold it, and gods, they may try for some high ground play here.
The Brute BKB kind of, some people might be like, oh, it's okay, they force out a Brute BKB, but this Brute doesn't need a 10-second BKB this game. He's not a carry in the sense that he needs to be staying alive to deal damage. The BKB is purely so that when he blinks in, claps, can throw a clap and a Drunken Haze before he ulties and not have to worry about the Orchid of Broodmother.
And if you do go late as Brew, you often get that Refresher Abyssal Blade, which is where you'll have a 10-second BKB potentially anyway. IG continuing to lay into the tower, but Arteezy doing what he does well. We saw it on his Naga back in the old days. We're seeing it now on the Shadow Fiend. He's going to stall the game. Split pushes, takes the tower. Secret making the right moves here. Although it does feel like they're up against it.
And doing damage to the range rack, so this is not going to regenerate on the IG side. It was a fairly low HP tower, so it was kind of like IG did a lot more damage to the base, but a tier 3 for a tier 3.
Look at this. They want to go right back in on the mid lane. They're going to make their jump. That's Faith with the stolen crush on 2. See you later, Secret, he says. And now they've got confidence, and they don't have a split push problem to worry about, Gods. IG straight up the mid. And this could be a late of Rex. It might be more. There's no tier 2s left standing. If Secret's on a buyback,
because they
don't.
Drone even?
They don't know. They might not know about these buybacks being down, but at the very least, you take one lip Rex. You see they're not buying back. You consider a second.
Absolutely. I feel like that is. This is the timing. You've still got Aegis on Queen of Pain. 430 is rocked back up, and you either go for another lane of Rex or you start poking at those tier 4s. And that's what Lua has in mind. Bottom
towards
lane.
Bottom. Even if Secret have 5, it's going to be tough for them to fight, but without it, how can they? Luo in the front
AC
here.
Arrives.
IG clumping up the ACs here and the Blake forward. They found S4 Hex and dead, it looks like, beaten down by the gang of IG heroes that descend on him as they look to make this best of 5, a best of 3. They get the crush off to turn it. The Requiem comes out, but nobody cares. The Bruce splits there. Luo tanks through it all. Cyclone doesn't get capped. They lose the Wind Panda. The Queen of Panda over the top. IG just laying into Secret. They'll bring down Arteezy. Can't save him with the embrace, and now they may lose more. BKB galore. 5 Echo Shadow Fiend. To what end, though? Puppy's dead. Arteezy's about to be the next on the list. He gets hexed again, and they continue crushing their way forward. Now the stun, the clap, they get him. Another death. It's a buyback for Arteezy, and IG have Secret by the throat. Any second now, expecting to see that GG out. Kuroki looks like he'll be the last man down. Soul Assumption continues to take auto attacks and will fall in the end. IG. Looks like they've made this a 1-1 series, Gods.
All right, there's no coming back from this deficit. It's at least another lane of Rax, and with that IG pull even further ahead, they did take 3 casualties, but this second lane of Rax, and where is the comeback potential on the Secret side? Slaughter had to buy back. He's got no BKB. Arteezy had to buy back that fight. That slows down his item progression, and Brood, just a hero who is already starting to fall off. Picked up a Desolator just for these last couple of fights, but
he's not going to get to use it.
They don't actually go for the second lane of Rax. They kind of get cold feet there with the Winter Wyvern buyback, and I guess maybe Secret going to... I mean, they can definitely hold on out. It's still just one lane down, but
it's just look at the net worth, though. Yeah. You've got a Visage who's almost as farmed as your own Shadow Fiend. That 430 Queen of Pain that lost mid, suddenly he's more farmed than Arteezy. It's going to be scaling Mount Everest here, to be honest, for Secret to come back.
And the timing is such that Roshan coming up in the next 1 to 4 minutes, that's going to be decent enough for the IG side. They can buy their next couple of items.
It feels like Secret has to try and like smoke and steal the Roshan or catch IG and then go into the pit, but it's going to be very risky to do that with the buyback and then the death on Arteezy again. If he dies again, it might end up just being the game. The swap to start, though. They do get Bernie. He's got BKB the Evasion. Too much for Secret for now. The stolen swap comes out. Faith with all the plays. Burning kept alive and should be able to turn this. He's still got the split. He's going to use it right before the crush. And now they swing back the other way. Onto Zai. Getting chased out. Still for now. Secret hanging on, but they've lost the Slaughter. They're going to lose Curl quickly. Cornered and just isolated completely. Faith again and again on the Rubik. Denying Secret. 4 dead. And G. Jay! The crowd gets a little excited as IG turn this best of 5 into a best of 3.
Well, with that, things even here between 2 of the best teams that have made it into the finals here. Secret and IG just putting on a bit of a show here. First, it was a pretty straightforward win for Secret, although IG really looked impressive even...